Hey, 173. Here I am at the California coastline. Drake's Pilsner lip. Separate my lip. It seems wrong that after all these years of doing this show, we have not shown you California in all of its glory. We got surfers, we got beautiful sand and rocks and people and things, lots of things. But hey, we also got a show to do, ladies and gentlemen. Another wonderful rerun. Another wonderful reason to send us money so that we can keep on recording new music for you. So, without further ado, 173 for you. Ow!
Somber intro there.
Yeah.
Do a little toast anyway.
Respect.
Out of respect.
The lady.
Yes, a respective. Retrospective.
I always loved that lady.
I did too. Clink. Lift.
Separate my lips.
Water. Man, that stuff's good.
Man. I can't drink water. Makes me sick.
That's out of left field.
Okay.
All right. Well, this is the Karen birthday show.
Happy birthday, Karen.
Yes, we did one last year. We're going to do it again. That's Bruce's sister.
I know she's gone today.
She's gone, so she doesn't really get to.
We were going to try to have the dogs running in here and making a big mess.
Anyway, so this is all her requests. And there's some pretty good tunes coming up. So here's one of my personal favorites from Alex Chilton and the Box Tops. Here we go. Ready?
Baby again, lonely days are gone, I'm a-going home, my baby, she Madden.
Awkward modulation on the guitar.
Yeah, I forgot it was happening.
Yeah, I did too.
Kind of caught me off guard there. But hey, oh, it's great to have everybody with us, and you know, let's all be happy together
somehow.
Imagine me and you. I do. I think about you day and night. It's only right to think about the girl you love and hold her tight, so happy together. If I should call you up, invest the time, and you say you belong to me, and ease my mind, imagine how the world could be so very fine, so happy together.
I can't get it. Now for something completely different. Off my steady job today.
I mean, where else can you go to hear The Letter and then Big City Turn Me Loose?
Yeah, man.
Who does that?
Well, Karen did it. But we do it. Coronasphere. We're the Coronaspheres, and we give you the songs you like to hear.
And today it's Karenosphere.
It's Karenosphere. Yeah, that's a... There you go, little buddy.
Karenosphere is...
Oh, man.
What... So, okay, so these are songs... These are songs that...
They're songs.
Man, this is... It's worth noting that my sister was an influence on me musically because she had all the records and things. You know, she had a lot going on. I would come in there and check out, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And so she was always ahead bringing these artists
in. We do have a lot to thank her for. And that's why we do these shows every year for her, because I was not aware of that influence. But
really?
Well,
She's my older sister. My middle sister loved music, but I don't know that she was as...
into
much
it.
Of a devotee of what my older sister was bringing into the house.
Well, Karen's still a major music fan. She's aware of
she's crazy.
Way more artists than I would imagine. I mean, she's got that wide palette.
Super wide.
That we have.
Crazy. So. Crazy cool. Way ahead of her time.
Well, now, Karen didn't request this one. I did, because we haven't done it for a long time. This is one of my favorites that I think kind of fits the bill.
All right.
Straight out of Warren Zevon via Linda Ronstadt.
It's almost like we know it.
Well, there's not a lot to it. I mean, three chords and the truth, the truthus. I broke
three
my
chords
three, the truthus. I broke my truthus.
Okay, well now here's one that a Karen requests that, man, when I went back and listened to this, like, I'm like, gosh, this is a straight 77s. A straight, you know, new 77s, old 77s kind of
thing.
Yeah,
it's a little bit like Closer, isn't it? And
it's got the Baybel.
Baybel. You mentioned the pink.
The Grails.
You thought that Bruce kind of, you know, since everyone's accusing Bruce Springsteen of ripping everyone off right now, I won't say his name. You said that you thought
that me?
You said that you thought he ripped this off to do his pink Cadillac.
I didn't say that.
Yes, you did.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
No, I said. I said he heard that and got a whole thing out of it. And then you're the one who.
Oh, then I took it to the ripoff level.
See, all you have to do is this note. You just talk things out a little bit. The allegation is made, and it just takes a little more conversation
I'm innocent of all charges
and find out what really happened.
Okay.
Try to sing some of this.
Oh yeah, I'll give you a verse.
But she packed up her bags and she took off down the road. Left me stranded with the bills that she owed. She gave me a false address. Took off with my American Express. She
That's a good one.
That's crazy.
That does sound like us. We should work it into our stage act.
Yeah, we should. Man, we
stage act.
We need to do the covers.
The covers? Yeah. Under the covers?
Under the covers. Yeah. That's it.
Uh-oh.
We need a companion disc to go with the two new ones that we're doing.
Yes.
And call it Under the Covers.
Under the Covers.
And feature all these covers we've been doing.
And show us in bed together.
And rock them out a little bit. Man, I'll tell you what. Yeah, there's a couple in this show that would be really great for that.
Oh, I think so.
Like Bert and Ernie.
You know,
Chris Harrison, ladies and gentlemen.
A lot of familiarity takes place after years and years of partnership. But yes, ladies and gentlemen, the Kazoo Master himself,
Mr. Christian A.
Hey, Harrelson.
Anyway, thanks for joining us again, as you do every week. We've had a busy time, man. You're out playing a lot with your two bands. Three bands. Three bands in a week. Four bands in a week.
Five bands. Let's make it six.
Yeah.
Well, Soon enough to be seven.
Boots. I would say in the last, 2 weeks you've played with...
Who was telling me they were saying, man, well, you're a drummer, you know, you can get gigs. You can go out and play with people, you know. It's like guitar players is harder. It's harder to age gracefully and still have gigs as a guitar player. What do you think about that, Mike?
Depends how good looking you are.
Wow.
First of all.
Not talent.
And if you keep your voice and you're good looking, that's really great. But some of these guys might look good still, but their voice is different. You know, like, I won't name names, but there's people whose voice is just either gone or it's totally different. Then there's guys that look terrible and sing terrible. So they got to have a lot of hits.
So are you basically saying that from now on, all your vocals are pristine and can't be criticized?
I would never say that.
Okay.
Only in the studio. And then if it's not, that's my fault.
And the only reason why you would say that in the studio is because nobody's in the studio but you. All right. So now here's one that I think this right here was requested. I think the Judas Priest version of this is what was requested.
What?
Yeah.
They did record this?
Oh, yeah. That's the first one I heard. How about you, Chris?
Yeah.
Yep.
Wow, I'm ignorant.
Yes, but you're actually closer to the source. And
well,
I don't mean to talk over such a...
Joan Baez wrote this for Bob Dylan. I didn't know how great of a lyricist she was. I would have thought Dylan wrote it, you know?
Well, she wrote it for him.
Wrote it for him, about him, yes. Wow. Here we go.
I'm going to listen.
Well, I'll be damned. Here comes your ghost again. But that's not unusual. It's just that the moon was full and you happened to call. Here I sit, hand on the telephone, hearing a voice I'd known a couple of light years ago, heading straight for a fall. As I remember, your eyes were bluer than robin's eggs. My poetry was lousy, you said. Where are you calling from? A booth in the Midwest. 10 years ago, I bought you some cufflinks. You brought me something. Know what memories can bring. They bring diamonds and rust. You burst on the scene
phenomenon, the original vagabond. You strayed into my arms, and there you stayed, temporarily lost at sea. The Madonna was yours for free. Yes, the girl on the half shell could keep you unharmed. Now I see you standing with brown leaves falling all around and snow in your hair. Now you're smiling out the window of that crummy hotel over Washington Square. Our breath comes out, white clouds mingles and hangs in the air. Speaking strictly for me, we both could have died then and there.
Song.
I take back everything I've ever said about her.
I'm telling you, man.
All of it.
All of it.
Yeah.
Right now.
Right now. Barely yeah. Right now.
I mean, Joan Baez is a required taste vocally, but songwriting-wise, just her accomplishments have been major, and that, I think, is her opus magnum for sure.
Well, we are moving forward to tippy, tippy, whippy, tippy canoe time, I think.
The tip show.
Thanks, everybody. You guys have been very generous. Very generous as of late, and we want to keep that trend going. So, paypal.me/... MICRO77S. I mean, there's no real polite way
to
say
listen, it. Listen, we just want to say that we hope all your trends are going to where you could even consider taking part of your valuable personal trends.
Yes, giving that everything's going
them
up.
Our way.
Since everything's going up, we would hope that our quality is also going up.
We would hope.
We would hope every day.
We would hope.
We do hope. We live with hope.
We would hope.
And, yeah, so gas has gone down, so there's that little shave there. And what else has gone down? I don't know.
It's gone down.
it's gone.
Yeah.
Yeah, they hiked it, what, $10, and then they brought it down a dollar.
Yeah, it's really going good, man.
Yeah, it's going good.
I mean, a lot of things are really going good.
Yeah, the show is free, though.
Really crazy.
And I'm going to remind you, on occasion I do, that we don't need the money overnight or instantly, so don't click that now button, because then you get charged, we get charged. Just say 2 to 3 days, let her ride on number 7, and send us the whole Marianne.
Put it all on number 77.
Yeah, if you like Venmo, it's at MICRO77S. If you like writing checks, we got one. We got another one. Very happy to say, 77SLTD.
And write us a letter, too. Please.
Well, yeah, well, they
write
did.
Write us a letter.
I do not get checks that don't have letters. Would you like me to share them with you?
Yes, we should be reading them on the show.
We should be reading them.
Specifically read letters from checks. It should be the letters from checks.
You know what? Maybe that's the way to get more checks. Because people tend to be more generous when they write checks. So if we read, if you send us a generous check.
But how about maybe that's a way to show some appreciation to the people that send the check?
Bruce, you know, we are Goofus and Gallant. I'm Goofus. He's Gallant. Goofus says inappropriate things, begging and pleading and shaming for money. Gallant, on the other hand, appreciates all that you do, whether you give or not.
Thank you very much.
All right. So read your highlights for children. 77SLTD, P.O. Box 1441, Citrus.
Please don't leave us hanging.
Heights.
From the edge of the precipice.
California, 95611.
That's stupid.
It's so weak.
I mean, don't you have a new one by now?
Come on, man. It's 122 of these.
Isn't there edge of eternity or edge of something?
Well, on the brink of humanity.
Yeah. I mean, you know, man stares out over the abyss.
All right. Speaking of staring out over the abyss, I believe that we need to stare out over the United States of America and bring
in North Kakalaki.
Marcuse Harmon Harmonious.
Hey, here he is in the box.
I'm
in the box.
Mark, hello.
Hello. How you guys doing?
What do you say this week?
Well, I just wanted to wish Miss Karen a very happy birthday.
Hi, Mark.
Hi, Mike.
Yeah, Mike's excited.
Look up at me, baby.
Mike.
I'll spit on you, baby. You're in the front row.
No.
Hey, man, we got some rockers for you.
We do.
Oh, but first off, let's do the hymn show. The
hymn show.
Promises salvation for everyone.
Well, maybe it's not.
Well, that might be ascribing a little bit more significance to it there.
I don't think we need to deliver that.
This song was written by Mr. Hank Williams himself, and it's been done in many traditions. The folk tradition by Mr. Jerome Garcia and his able-bodied assistant.
Is his name Jerome?
Yeah.
Oh,
take it to Jerome. Take it to Jerome. His able-bodied assistant, none other than Dave Dog Grisman and Tony Rice, the guitarist, whom I met and got him to sign my CD.
Oh.
And I handed it to him. It's the pizza tapes, you know. Oh. And he looked at that and he goes, this was kind of a goofy little thing. And I said, yeah, it was really great, actually.
Mark in?
Yeah, I don't want it to drag. Stop.
sounds nice.
Nice market.
Nice
speed.
Little North Carolina feel to that.
A little bit of cackle-lacky.
Yeah.
All right, well, this one goes.
Well, it looks like I'm going to have to do some capo.
Here's another
capo
this,
action.
Uh-oh. Would this qualify as hymn show?
In a
cautionary kind of way?
Yeah.
Yeah, in a goofy kind of way.
Well, yeah, it is. It is a little sarcastic. So
what
who did this thing?
A capo 1 and 3, open F.
Who did this song?
The Ozark Mountain Daredevils.
Oh,
the Daredevils. The same guys that did Jackie Blue.
Was that Jim Dandy or that? No, that was...
No, that was Black Oak
Arkansas.
Yeah, there's a lot... In the 70s, it seemed like there was a lot of bands that used those kind of... drawn on the Ozark kind of names, you know. And it's amazing that they were able to get hits with names like that, you know.
It was popular. It was trendy.
What's harder is to get to have a song like Jackie Blue, which sounds almost like mid-period Fleetwood Mac with Christine McVie.
Oh,
it sounded like a girl singing, and it wasn't. It was a dude.
Wow, that's a trip. I didn't realize that was him.
I didn't realize this was them. Same band.
Yeah.
So they must have been a great live act. I think they were popular probably in the South and Midwest. Yeah, more of a regional kind of deal, you know.
Doing a little bit of that Southern soul.
Could be.
Southern soul.
Well,
Mark, did you play any Ozark Mountain Daredevils when you were with Susie and the Homewreckers?
Oh, gosh, no. Nope.
All right, so, well, anyway, that's cool. I
Hey, you cut him off, man.
I'm sorry, man.
hold on a second. Continue. Tell that story.
I'm just saying, you know, the Homewreckers, we were a rockabilly band.
Well, now, you were in college at that time.
Oh, yeah.
Was that college age?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Young man. Yup.
Okay. Now we're running out of time. So
okay.
Hold that. Now, Southern guys like to tell a lot of stories.
No.
So we're going to keep that rest of that one for part two of this here.
We keep it.
Part two of 122, which is 123. So let's do this.
To raise a little
didn't know where I was going with that.
That was an interesting, interesting little tease there.
Yeah.
That's not in that song, is it?
No, none of that stuff
is.
That's
you.
I don't know
that's
where you went.
That's you putting mic. That's just you customizing it.
Well, yeah, I got lost in the soul. I was like, where did we go here? We probably should have worked on that one a little bit. Anyway.
A little bit. Thank you, Mark.
Well, thanks, Mark.
Hey.
Well, it's been great.
This one's the last one. This one, you know, one. I used to go into my sister's room and look at these records from this guy. And I don't know anybody else who had this guy's records. Did you have these records when you were young?
I have no idea what we're doing.
Oh,
Dwight Twilley from Tulsa, Oklahoma.
Oh, yeah.
You had Dwight Twilley records?
Yeah,
I would say that he wouldn't you say, Chris, that would be a close cousin to Big Star and what was happening in Memphis?
Oh, for sure.
That Dwight had a band in Tulsa.
What was the other, the big Dwight Twilley tune?
This one.
Really?
He did have another one. I can't remember the name of it right now. I'm a bit thrown off by just the excitement in the room right now.
Yeah, I confuse it with David Bowie. Because I remember my sister had two 45s. One was Dwight Twilley, and the other was David Bowie.
And that
and I was
confused
like,
you.
Yeah, one was Fame, and then the other one was the Dwight Twilley. I can't remember what it was, you guys. Somebody.
No, I messed you up, didn't I?
Somebody write that on a letter.
Man, I was all in tune.
And send Mike a check.
All right.
And hey. And you can feel free to fold it into an airplane.
Tune that.
And we'll
man.
Fly it on the show.
Wow.
We'll fly it back and forth from me to Chris.
We can it's have down like, to flying paper airplanes.
Then we
on
can
the
have
show.
A contest to see whose check flies the best and doesn't bounce.
Exactly.
Wow.
That's more mercenary than anything I said earlier.
Well, we're devotees of the doc. Hey, listen, everybody, thank you so much. All kidding aside, I mean, all this, whatever he's saying aside, sincerely.
Yeah.
I would like to thank you on behalf of the crew and the star.
The bond.
What? Listen, man.
People don't realize that. I mean, let's be honest, man. In order to do this, Mike has to have a room set aside with a star on the door.
And a blow dryer.
With his name on it. I mean, he can't get into it. It's a closet, actually, but it does have... There is a room here with the micro dressing room. It's in the rider.
All right. Well, this isn't going to get any more in tune than this.
Okay,
so ready?
Your friends are 99. Honey, you ain't got no love.
at the helm.
Mark Harmon, please.
Everybody now.